If you are new to Source Filmmaker, you might not be aware that you can download models from other sites than the Steam Workshop. Installing models downloaded from these sites is incredibly easy. These files are usually zip, rar, or 7-zip archives. It's essentially a collection of files and folders neatly packaged up in a single compressed archive. By default, Windows only supports the zip format, but people will often use 7-zip or rar files since they make the files much smaller. We'll use common software to unpack them. If you do not have either Winrar or 7-zip installed, I recommend doing so right away. My personal preference is 7-zip since it is free and open source, whereas Winrar is a commercial shareware program with some limits for trial users. Links to both programs will be provided in the video description. While I will use 7-zip in this tutorial, the workflow is nearly identical, so feel free to follow along with the software of your choice. Let's open the model archive with our zip program. You will see that inside there are folders named Materials and Models, or some variation of this, which we'll get to later. There might be others, but the Models and Materials folder are the ones you will want to watch out for. Also, if there is a text file included, give it a read. It may have important instructions or notes from the author. The folders you find in the zip file need to be copied to a specific spot in your Source Filmmaker installation directory. The path should be visible on your screen. You can locate that specific folder on your hard drive by right-clicking Source Filmmaker in your Steam games list, going to Manage and click Browse Local Files. This opens up an Explorer window, likely containing the folder named Game. Inside this game folder is your Source Filmmaker installation. You will see several folders here. The most important directory for our purposes is the UserMod directory. The UserMod directory is a game content folder where we can drop our custom models, materials and maps. If you look inside the UserMod directory, you will find the critical folders we're looking for, materials and models. What you want to do is drag and drop the Materials and Models folder from your zip file into your UserMod directory. Windows will prompt you about merging these folders, which is what we want to do. And that's basically it. It's very simple once you know where to find these folders. Keep in mind that you will generally need to copy and merge these folders in such a way that the directory structure is preserved. Moving the files to the wrong folders will result in your models or materials failing to load. If you don't see the models in Source Filmmaker, ensure you selected the right mod and directory in the model picker. If you had SFM open while you copied the models, you might have to hit rescan in the model picker or restart Source Filmmaker. There are a few variations of this pattern to account for. In the case of maps, you might also find a maps folder that matches the one in the UserMod directory. Or for example, if you open the archive, you might find a UserMod folder and perhaps a platform folder. If this is the case, then the directory structure inside the UserMod folder will usually match the one in the Source Filmmaker installation folder. You can copy these in a similar manner, as long as you preserve the directory structure. As long as you pay attention to the names of the files you're copying, you'll be installing models in only a few seconds. This video was made possible thanks to our Patreon supporters. Give the video a like if it was useful to you, and subscribe to the channel for more. And if you can afford it, support us through Patreon. Thank you for watching.